everybody. It's Jordan here. So, let's go ahead. I'm going to do here for my first video, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It just got added to the Xbox One backwards compatibility, and this is a game that I love and I know in and out extremely well. So, let's go ahead and get going. Let's go ahead and start a new game and we'll create a character. So, feels like old times. Reminds me of being a young child. Oh, I don't want to be a rogue. An explorer. Let's be the explorer. I want to do a custom character. What do we want to look like? That's a good one. I like that one. We'll increase our strength, dexterity. We'll get this all up to at least here. And then we'll add a little bit of charisma. We'll add wisdom. We'll go 15 on intelligence. There we go. Skills. Well, definitely want a good bit in computer. Awareness. Security. And then treat injury. Okay. Not that they'll put anything in. So let me make sure if I want to put anything in stealth. Let's take one out of tree injury and put in demolition. Let's go for tree injury. Awareness one. Okay. There we go. Let's go for my feats. Well, two weapon fighting, caution. Okay, so I do have a little bit hand-to-hand. Let's go ahead for... Let's go ahead and get Gearhead. Oh, Jesus. Add feet. Okay. Name. Let's go for the random. Ooh, Owen Star. Like that one. So we're Owen Star. Going. God, it's so awesome to see this game again. 4,000 years before the rise of the Galactic Empire, the Republic verges on collapse. Darth Malak, last surviving apprentice of the Dark Lord Raven, has unleashed an invincible Sith armada upon an unsuspected galaxy. Crushing all resistance, Malak's war of conquest has left the Jedi Order scattered and vulnerable as countless knights have fallen in battle and many more swear allegiance to the new Sith Master. In the skies above the outer rim world of Terrus, a Jedi battle fleet engages the forces of Darth Malak in a desperate effort to halt Sith galactic dominance. Gosh, I love this. Now I just can't wait till they add number 2.
We've been ambushed by a Sith battle fleet. The Endar Spire is under attack. Hurry up, we don't have much time. Did you fall out of your bunk and hit your head? The Endar Spire is the ship we're stationed on. This ship. You probably don't even know who I am, do you? I'm Trask Ulgo, ensign with the Republic Fleet. I'm your bunkmate here on the Endar Spire. We work opposite shifts. I guess that's why you haven't seen me before. Now hurry up, we have to find Bastila. We have to make sure she makes it off the ship alive. You swore an oath to protect Bastila when you signed up with this mission, just like everyone else in the crew. Now it's time to make good on that oath. I know she may not have an official rank in the fleet, but she's the one in charge of this mission, and it's our duty to protect her. I heard what everyone's saying about you. You've explored the farthest reaches of the galaxy. You've visited planets I've never even heard of. People with your skills and abilities are hard to find. It's no wonder the Republic recruited you for this mission. But now's the time to prove yourself. I know you're a scout and not a soldier, but Bastila needs all troops at her side during this attack. So hurry up and grab your gear. You need to suit up so we can get out of here.
Journal. I know. Attack on the new spider. Okay.
Okay, let's move out. We should stick together. You'll have more success with a party than on your own. Because of the attack, this room is in lockdown. But don't worry, I've got the override code. You'll have to use me to unlock the door. Now that the door is open, you better take the lead again.
Okay. What? Sure.
This is Carthel Nassi. The Sith are threatening to overrun our position. We can't hold out long against their firepower. All hands to the bridge!
That was Carth contacting us on our portable communicators. He's one of the Republic's best pilots. He's seen more combat than the rest of the Endar Spire's crew put together. If he says things are bad, you better believe it. We have to get to the bridge to help defend Bastila. There's a map of the Endar Spire and a copy of Karth's message in your electronic journal, just in case we get separated.
I know how to use my journal. I know how to do all
that. That door's locked, and I don't have the code. No problem.
Security.
These Sith must be the advanced boarding party for the Republic!
What? Yes? What? What?
Double blade or the dual lightsaber. Okay. med pack. Another med pack.
It's a dark Jedi. This fight is too much for us. We better stay back. All we do is get in the way.
Crap. She won.
That was one of the Jedi accompanying Bastila. Damn, they could have used her help.
Excuse me. Change which hands I have weapons in.
Bastila is not here on the bridge. They must have retreated to the escape pods. We better head that way too. The Sith want Bastila alive, but once she's off the ship, there's nothing stopping them from blasting the Endar Spire into galactic dust.
Okay.
I'll try to hold him off. You get to the escape pods. Go!
I was expecting to pull off the dark Jedi. There's no way to help him. Which is sad. Okay, starboard section of the ship. It's saving. Yay! Okay.
This is Carthel Nassi on your personal communicator. I'm tracking your position through the Endar Spire's life support systems. Bastila's escape pod is away. You're the last surviving crew member on the Endar Spire. Now, I can't wait for you much longer. You have to get to the escape pods. Some way to thin their numbers. You could reprogram the damaged assault droid to help you if you have enough repair parts. Or you could use computer spikes to slice into the terminal and use the Endar Spire's security systems against the Sith.
Or you could use both. Prototype Viro Blade. Viro Blades are like these vibrating blades.
You've made it just in time. There's only one active escape pod left. Come on, we can hide out on the planet below. I'm a soldier with the Republic, like you. We're the last two crew members left in the Endar Spire. Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so there's no reason for us to stick around here and get shot by the Sith. Now, come on! There'll be time for questions later.
Okay, Carthel Nassi.
Bastila's escape pod's already gone, so...
let's take this escape pod and go. Okay.
Good to see you up instead of thrashing about in your sleep. You must have been having one hell of a nightmare. I was wondering if you were ever going to wake up. I'm Karth, one of the Republic soldiers from the Endar Spire. I was with you in the escape pod. Do you remember?
I'm
been slipping in and out of consciousness for a couple of days now, so I imagine you're pretty confused about things. Try not to worry. We're safe. At least for the moment. We're in an abandoned apartment on the planet of Terrace. We were banged up pretty bad when our escape pod crashed, but luckily I wasn't seriously hurt. I was able to drag you away from our crash site and all the confusion, and I stumbled into this abandoned apartment. By the time the Sith arrived on the scene, we were long gone. Terrace is under Sith control. Their fleet is orbiting the planet, they've declared martial law, and they've imposed a planet-wide quarantine. But I've been in worse spots. I saw on your service records that you understand a remarkable number of alien languages. That's pretty rare in a raw recruit. But it should come in handy while we're stranded on a foreign world. There is no way the Republic will be able to get anyone through the Sith blockade to help us. If we're gonna find Bastila and get off this planet, we can't rely on anybody but ourselves. That smack to your head did more damage than I thought. Bastila's a Jedi. She was with the strike team that killed Darth Revan, Malak's Sith master. Bastila's the key to the whole Republic war effort. The Sith must have found out that she was on the Ender Spire and set an ambush for us in this system. I believe Bastila was on one of the escape pods that crashed down here in Terrace. For the sake of the Republic war effort, we have to try and find her. I don't think you understand the situation. But we can't hide on this planet forever. Eventually the Sith will find us, and trust me, you don't want that. Getting off this world isn't gonna be easy. We're probably gonna need Bastila's help. Not to mention that without her, the whole Republic war effort is doomed. Bastila's gonna need our help. Many of Darth Malak's followers have mastered the dark side of the Force, and the Sith have already killed more than their share of Jedi in this war. I doubt anyone's specifically looking for us anymore. We're not that important, but if we're careful, we can move about the planet without attracting notice, a luxury Bastila won't have. She's gonna have half the Sith fleet looking for her. They know how vital she is to the war effort. Bastila's no ordinary Jedi. She has a rare gift the Jedi call battle meditation. Bastila's power can influence entire armies. Through the Force, Bastila can inspire her allies with confidence and make her enemies lose their will to fight. And often that's all it takes to tip the balance in a battle. But there are limits to what she can do. From what I understand of her ability, it requires great concentration and focus to maintain her battle meditation. The attack on the Endar Spire happened so fast, she probably never even had a chance to use her power. I'm guessing she barely got out alive, and now she's trapped here just as we are. The whole planet is under quarantine. No ships can land or take off. So if Bastila's gonna escape Terrace, she's gonna need our help, and we'll probably need hers.
Great, we gotta get her help.
Don't be a fool. You're not getting off this world without help. You can't hide here forever. Do you have any idea what will happen when the Sith find you? Good. We're gonna need to work together if we're gonna survive. While you were out, I did some scouting around. There are reports of a couple of skate pods crashing down into the Undercity. It's probably a good place to start. But the Undercity's a dangerous place. We don't want to go there unprepared, and it won't do Bastila any good if we go and get ourselves killed. Good idea. We can use this abandoned apartment as a base. We can probably get some equipment and supplies here in the Upper City. Just remember to keep a low profile. I've heard some grim stories about the Dark Jedi interrogation techniques. They say the Force can do terrible things to a mind. Can wipe away your memories and destroy your very identity. But I figure if we don't do anything stupid, we should be okay. I mean, after all, they're looking for Bastila, not a couple of grunts like us. All right, soldier, let's move out.
I'm trying to tell them what to do. Upgrade item, yes. I'll use the workbench. I'll upgrade it.
Yes, what's on your... Me? Well, I've been a star pilot for the Republic for years. Seen more than my share of wars. I fought in the Mandalorian Wars before all this started. But with all that, I've never experienced anything like the slaughter these Sith animals can unleash. Not even the Mandalorians were that senseless. My homeworld was one of the first planets to fall to Malak's fleet. The Sith bombed it into submission, and there wasn't a damn thing our Republic forces could do to stop them. It shouldn't be my fault. I did everything I could. I followed my orders and did my duty. That shouldn't mean I failed them. I didn't. I know that. I'm not angry at you. Don't think that. I must not be making much sense. You probably mean well with your questions. I'm just not accustomed to talking about my past very much. At all, actually. I'm more used to taking action, keeping my mind focused on the business at hand. So let's just do that. If you have more questions...
Okay, cars. Yep, Karth Onassi.
Okay, you alien scum. Everybody get up against the wall. This is a raid. That's how we should deal with smart-mouthed aliens. Now the rest of you get up against the wall before I lose my temper again. Hey, what's this? Humans hiding out with aliens? They're Republic fugitives. Attack!
You're as bad as that pig Holden. I'll stay out. You again. I can't help you there. Since this thing with Holden, I've been scared to leave my apartment. Just one of Darvik's men who can't keep his hands to himself. But all he got for his trouble was a nasty scar from my vibroblade. Too bad I'm the one still paying the price. I don't want to talk about... Well, I suppose you seem like an all right sort. When I cut Holden, it made him back off, but it also embarrassed him in front of his friends. Holden's a spiteful little hut slug. He went and put out a bounty on my head for what I did. That's why I'm hiding out here. Wait, think about what you're doing. If that pig had just kept his hands to himself, I wouldn't have had to... He gets drunk and tries to force himself on me, and I get a bounty put on my head for defending myself. Where's the justice in that?
What's wrong with you? She doesn't deserve...
Then you're going to let...
Dark side points.
Look, I know we're trying to keep a low profile.
Kuyami Jus Runda di Hotonga Kun Hunkabi. Wanna kun bez ching pala mule tunking ba no tek.
Tokin
chatu kunde mule rabes. Kachi kun ida hotonga. Yikin kuno ba mule rachi kun. Slimo podona tong abom sha umnino wonga kumbis king tag this jupunko koki bakpaka ching pala chiska mule tunarana nu prata tunko sicha tuma wamamatus keba toma nisha julorcha kinguno bulera chiko Chan Shok Purara, Umrao Jiska Duchi, On Chuban Jiska Yanki, Titoke Kratun, Kun Chichakun, Kin, Kacha Chonobra, Bogra Wala Nutumbacha, Nechi Chuna Chubaching, Lorda Itakun. We tam Boragatong, Mulira Ashanturung omni, Na Potata Twangachun Tize. Igrutu haga jijiwa? What a juma wana hu wama hulhu na tek? Si gratu loda pograshi oniu kompa chintombo muchuba. Loda nita kun. Ita patisa batua kacha tutong. Bagrasha kun tijaka Chuba kaha chopa chawachwish yunku. Jodo jidbungarantang. Mucha shak bakhan. Achuta.
I don't want to sell stuff, so...
Achuta.
Virus sword.
Okay, good, good. Let's go ahead.
Oh. Achuta.
I'm gonna go ahead and sell my long sword here.
Hakupa. We eat a non diet. What the? Tag, Bijan Shah. We eat a. She got Mujashak Bach. Yikukum Takum just stuck run the deep. Achuta.
Okay, let's just go.
Problem.
Got it. So we'll take some stuff. That's good. And nothing in here. It's to the upper city.
Koyami, Jivu Chichita na Padota, Yafulki Kokala Gigi, Kawanabora Atubawa, Kanki do Rakun, Watimi Alabola.
What? Oh, I get. You'll change your tune the first time you're.
There's no need to antagonize them.
Well, we'll see.
Yes, there is. There's always reason to antagonize them, man. Because I antagonize people. It's just what I do. Go to the Upper City South. Okay, then let's check our journal entry. The Star Central Republic has a rapid transit system allowing you to move quickly through the game. You can access the rapid transit system through your map. Data's bounty. Cars.
Sure.
Greetings and good day. I am a Pentagon. Then if you will excuse.
You looking to buy some supplies? My shop's the largest one in all of Upper Terrace. Best select.
Mostly. What do you mean by that?
The Sith confiscated all my heavy weapons, and they impounded all my ships and swoop bikes. But I've still got a real nice selection, if you're interested. Anything I can do to help a potential customer out. What do you want to know? I heard a couple of pods crash down in the Undercity. I bet the crash sites have already been stripped clean by the Sith, though. Unless the swoop gangs or Davix men got there first. Oh, Davix a legitimate businessman, if you get my drift. Smuggling, slaving, extortion. Mm-hmm. They say he's a member of the Exchange, you know, the big intergalactic criminal organization.
Hmm. Well, I've heard of the Exchange. Bad organization to cross. But if anyone has blockade-breaking ships, however, it's them.
I have to pay them a protection fee every month, but it's reasonable. And I get most of my inventory through Davik and his suppliers. I'm just smart enough not to ask where it came from, you understand? Davik hates the Sith as much as anybody. The quarantine has put a real dent in his operations, too. But he's keeping a low profile as long as the occupation lasts. Davik stays out of the way, and the Sith don't bother him. The swoop gangs could learn a thing or two from this tidy little arrangement instead of always going after each other. I don't have anything good to say about those swoop gangs, zooming around on their swoop bikes, terrorizing the lower city like a bunch of animals. Things weren't so bad when the Hidden Vex were running the show, but ever since the rise of the Black Volker gang, the lower city has been nothing short of a war zone. The Sith haven't even bothered trying to maintain order down there, and I heard a rumor that Davik's own people are having problems with the Black Volkers now. It's not smart to say bad things about the people in power, if you get my meaning. I just wish the Sith would ease up on the quarantine, though. They're killing my business. I can't say I like having them here in Upper City, but it could be worse, and we're still a lot better off than the Lower City, what with those swoop gangs and all. Oh, you're one of those... Oh, you can't be too happy. Trapped on an unfamiliar world and all. But Terrace isn't so bad, as long as you stay in the Upper City. Just try to avoid the Sith. And stay out of the Lower City. The swoop gangs are totally out of control. Even Davik's men are having trouble down there. Good day to you, then.
Okay. And then let's go to the bar.
Didn't work.
I tried to do something out of the bar. God, play smart, Jordan. Play smarter, not hard.
Don't you just love watching the Pazak? All that strategy.
I don't know if I'll play any Pazak.
All those credits. It's enough to make a girl get all fl-
Pazak's fun, but...
Hi there. I haven't seen you around before. I'm off duty right now, so I'm not in uniform. I'm actually a little surprised you're talking to me at all. Say the sympathetic bit, but I don't want to fill out a bunch of...
What? What? Get away from me. No hard feelings. Surely you understand what I'm talking...
I don't know what the guy...
Well, people complain, but things are the Sith...
No hard feelings, my good man. Surely you understand what I'm talking...
Where did you get?
Careful what you say. I get the feeling this spoiled brat could cause us.
Why is the hell? How dare you?
Do I know you?
This cantina isn't the fence.
If you're here to complain about the poor...
You know, it's bad enough the Sith conquered this planet.
You aren't from Terrace, are you? Do yourself a favor and stay away from the tree fan. Packs more kick than most rotten rovers can handle.
Here's the...
I can't believe we couldn't get arena tickets for this match! Now...
Who cares? It's Duncan and Gurlon fighting. It's not like we're gonna miss anything good.
Shh, they're about to start, so quit complaining and just watch the view screen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I draw your attention to the dueling ring. Here, two combatants will battle for your viewing and gambling enjoyment. Now, I hope all your bets are down because we're ready to roll. In this corner, I give you Gerlon Two-Finger. And over here, looking to climb the ranks yet again, is the ever-persistent Jedi Duncan. And to nobody's great surprise, Jedi is down again. Don't worry, folks. He's just unconscious. As usual, our medics will have him up and about in a bit. Well, that was quick, wasn't it? So I give you the winner.
Let's go ahead and do a... Let's go ahead and talk to her about doing the fight.
Vibroblades and blasters, and nobody ever
does.
This is for the best. We could use those credits from these duels, but using your real name is too risky.
Fight Jedi Duncan real fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eyes to the center ring. We have a very special... You've seen him lose night after night after night, but this time... He's after fresh meat. And in the other corner, a relative newcomer to the terrace dueling scene, emerging from the shadows with no history, no past, and no name, the mysterious stranger!
Bam! One hit and you down.
It's over! The fight is over! The mysterious stranger has won! But really, are it...
Losing to Deadeye?
Ha! Jiyokakon! Ha! Parish Makuchikop!
Ladies and gentlemen, draw in this corner. One of the greats, a man so tough, even a disfiguring injury couldn't end his career. And in the other corner.
Down.
It's over! The fight is over! The Maskerlon losing to a rookie! Is this a sign?
Nope, I'm just that good. I'll go up against ice.
Ladies and gentlemen, draw your eye over in this corner. A woman with steel on her bones and ice water in her veins. She's cold and quick as death. And in the other corner, a rising star taking that first step into the big leagues. I give you the mysterious stranger.
still got.
The Stranger in Ice wins! Once again, the Queen of...
Okay, well, we'll come back for Ice.
She has one of the strongest jet to fight. Surprise to
Uchan, you Tadapudo.
Not right now. I'll get her in a match against her after we go explore somewhere. Oh, that's a good guy. Although, next time I come back in here, I'll finish talking. Maybe I'll even do some Pazak. Pazak. Not Pazak, Pazak.
You need a lesson on how to treat your social betters. Maybe you'll think great. Daddy!
Talking bad about me, girl. What'd you expect to happen? Her little friends protect her? No. Daddy's money might be able to buy her friends, but his daddy's money.
Out of our way, citizen. We're unofficial Sith business. Just stand aside if you know what's good for you.
Okay, sorry, Sith.
What are you doing? Don't go in there! That door is for employees only!
You recognize these soldiers? But how? Unless you're a friend of the Republic.
What? No! You don't tell the Sith! Please! I can explain all this.
Since the space battle overhead, people have been secretly bringing in these Republic soldiers who crash-landed on the planet. I had to take them in. What choice did I have? Their injuries are terrible. Most won't survive. But at least I can make their last days more comfortable. And at least here they're hidden away from the Sith.
Well, for that you have my thanks. It's good to know that at least some of these men ended up in compassionate hands.
I hate to imagine what the Sith would do if they discovered these soldiers here. But since their initial questioning, the Sith have not returned, so it may be my fears are unfounded. I'm afraid there's nothing more anyone can do for these soldiers. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should return to the front in case anyone comes in needing medical attention.
Aww, life side points.
I see from your appearance, do you require heat? The terrible affliction has plagued Tereth. Prolonged exposure to the Undercity breeds the disease, and those infected will eventually mutate into Rakghouls themselves, becoming mindless there is no antidote for the disease. Though I heard the Republic scientists at the military base here on Terrace were close to perfecting it. They overran the military base, and now they refuse to allow anyone access to the laboratories inside. The Sith are keeping... If I could just get my hands on a sample of... I don't see how anyone... I suppose the Sith patrol's in the under... But I doubt a patrol... Please, don't say that! I only mentioned... I am quite busy, mate. I know enough to be scared. So far, all they've done is ask. I guess there's not much I can do about the Sith. I am quite busy. All I know is what I was told by the people who brought these Republic soldiers here for treatment. The Undercity is a wasteland, crawling with flesh-eating mutants called Rakghouls. I feel sorry for the outcasts that are forced to live there. Justice here on Terrace is swift and harsh. There are only two punishments, execution or banishment to the Undercity. Anyone banished can never return on pain of death. Even their descendants are forced to live in the depths beneath our great cities. Whenever I can, I send supplies to the Undercity to help ease the misery of their lives. Although there is nothing I can do to help those infected with the Rakghoul disease. The lower city has been overrun by swoop gangs and thugs. If you're going to travel down there, you'd better go armed. If you don't get attacked by one of the swoop gangs, you'll probably end up beaten and robbed by one of Davik's thugs. Soon it will be as bad as the Undercity. I am quite busy, mate. Of course.
Yes?
Psst, you there.
Zelka isn't the only one who wants to get his hands on the rat. Look, Zelka... Davik isn't the guy. The best thing to do is to take the rat ghoul serum to Zax. He runs the Lower City Bounty Office, but everyone knows he also works for Dap. Look. Davik's interested in anything that can...
And then only the rich...
If you find the rat...
Davik says you missed your lap.
Here, I've got 50.
Sorry, you're out of time.
But I don't have that much. No.
I know we have to be careful about drawing attention.
Hold on a second. Looks.
Thank you. I owe you my life. Now I can't pay.
Are you joking? We don't need this guy's crap.
I'm getting out of here.
Waiting for fun. My best credits.
Let's go to the Upper City North. Goes to some apartments, which I will want to explore at some point.
Yes, what's on your mind? I guess I did say you could. We're pretty snappy with the orders, aren't we? Let me ask you something first, though. I've been going through the battle aboard the Endar Spire. Oh, some things just don't add up for me. Neither was I, to tell the truth. I was on board as an advisor for the most part. The battle began so fast, it's anyone's guess as to what actually happened. We lost the ship and a lot of good people on it. For what? In the hope that the Jedi powers would save us somehow? Not that Bastila had much of an opportunity to act. We didn't choose that battle anyway. It got forced on us. Hell, I'm just as surprised that any of us are alive to talk about it. Come to think of it, it's more than a little surprising that you happen to be here, isn't it? I mean, just what is your position with the Republic fleet anyway? Well, that makes sense. Still, it seems a bit strange that someone who is a last-minute addition to the crew roster is one of the survivors. No? Well, maybe. Don't get me wrong, it just seems odd that someone Bastila's party specifically requested to transfer aboard happens to survive. I'm not trying to be paranoid. It's just that I learned a long time ago the Jedi requested numerous things when they came on board. I mean, hell, they practically took over the ship. Considering your connection to Bastila and the Jedi, whether you know it or not, your presence here seems a little convenient. I'm probably wrong, and this is probably nothing. I expect you're right. Look, it has nothing to do with you. And no, I'm not going to discuss them. So... all right, we'll talk about it.
What is this?
Shouldn't you go to the Lower Sejupo?
Oh, this is rich.
Yeah, like he said. Hey, this schlemmy.
Oh, great. We're fighting the...
You talk.
Time to teach you a... Yes, we're killing the drones.
Just dark side.
We must go to the dark side.
Through our streets. We cannot sit idly by while this hawks and pecks our society.
Okay. Sith headquarters.
This elevator is it's obvious from the way you're dressed that you're not... If you were supposed to have them, you'd know it. I'm not here to give you information.
Let's read the last one. Okay. Find a way to close.
Listen to me, people. There is a terrible scourge sweeping our planet. Heed my warning before it is too late.
Back to the base. Let's go back inside the apartment. Okay. Go ahead and save my game here. Well, I greatly appreciate you guys for watching. Now, I know this is a pretty long video here, but wanted to get a good bit into this game. This is my first video here that I'm actually getting put up off my AverMedia 2 Live, well, AverMedia Live Game Reportable 2. So, thank you guys for watching. If you like the video, go ahead and like it down below. And if you want to see more, go ahead and subscribe. Thank you guys. Have a wonderful time.